You know, I lost almost $3 million last year in power quality issues.
Oh, that's a lot. Didn't you just buy a bunch of Power Xpert meters? What are they telling you?
Well, the consultant told me what to buy, and the electrician, he came down and put them in, but to be honest, I haven't really thought of using them as a troubleshooting tool.
Here at the Power Systems Experience Center, we have seen countless similar situations where customers have purchased our Power Xpert meters, but didn't realize how useful these meters are for analyzing their power system. In this video, we'll show you some of the things that you can do with this powerful tool that you may not be aware of. Let's have a look. First of all, Power Xpert meters were designed with you in mind. They're easy to configure and easy to view. We took the advanced capabilities of a $20,000 power quality instrument and combined that with a revenue accurate power meter. We learned that no one wants to load special software on their computer just to work with the meter. So we designed the Power Xpert meters to have everything accessible from a browser. We also learned that security is critical, so we use the latest encryption and cybersecurity standards so that only authorized people can get this easy access. For basic analysis, let's start off by looking at the metering page. The Power Xpert meter captures all the important signals, including voltage, current, and power parameters, thousands of times every cycle. This means it can capture transient events that exist only for nanoseconds, but can also intelligently process such a large quantity of data to find the transient anomalies. The EKG of the power system is the waveform capture. Waveforms can be triggered from pre-programmed or user-programmed events, or you can take a manual snapshot of the waveforms for voltage and current, as well as the phasor diagrams and harmonic spectrum. But what really sets it apart is that you can view and trend all of these parameters for line-to-line, line-to-neutral, neutral-to-ground, and symmetrical components for each of the voltages and currents. Most meters force you to select either line-to-line or line-to-neutral measurements. With captured events, you can also view line-to-ground or neutral-to-ground, giving you more options for troubleshooting issues like arcing ground faults. Performing a Fourier analysis on the arcing current and voltage waveforms provides localization data to help pinpoint the site of a ground fault. In addition, on the power page, you can view and trend power factor, kVA, kilowatts, and reactive power per phase or as a three-phase rollup. The meter can display power factor with harmonics, also known as apparent power factor, or will display displacement power factor, which is what utilities companies' bills are based on. Displacement power factor is only calculated using the fundamental, or here in North America, the 60 hertz part of the voltage and current. If you want to go deeper into analysis, trends of the voltage and current harmonics and flicker are available on the quality page. All these parameters are helpful in analyzing your power system, but data in that format still puts the analysis on your shoulders. So we've taken it a step further with the dashboard view. On the dashboard home screen, you can see all the voltage, current, and power parameters for your system plotted on a statistical graphic. This graphic doesn't show you what your 480 volt system should be, but rather it shows you a statistical view for how your system is doing compared to its historical normal parameters. This view shows the statistical average for each value and indicates an upper and lower statistical range representing +1 and -1 standard deviation around the mean value shown as the middle value. In other words, the signal falls somewhere within this middle range 68% of the time. At our electrical headquarters building, we noticed that the average voltage was running about 505 volts on our 480 volt system, and the upper boundary was over 525 volts. This means that 16% of the time, the voltage was higher than 525 volts. What had happened was we had a large fixed capacitor bank that we used for power factor correction, and overnight, under light load conditions, the voltage climbed very high, damaging power supplies and lighting ballasts. The Power Xpert meter diagnosed the problem, and an automated switching system and transformer tap change helped to regulate the voltage to a more reasonable level. The thermometers on this dashboard are a quick visual to let you know the state of your power quality in the past 10 minutes and 24 hours. Harmonics, voltage sags, and interruptions quickly raise the status from normal to alert. Within the setup function, you have multiple levels of alert and email notifications when limits are exceeded. Triggering on the Power Xpert 4, 6, or 8,000 meters is very simple. Just select any of the measured parameters from the meter or quality page and set a limit. If the Power Xpert meter senses that a value changes to something outside the range it thinks is normal, it will capture all the parameters and waveforms that you indicate in the trigger setup. With the Power Xpert 6000 and 8000 meters, the parameters for some of the most common power quality events are predefined and triggers are set like the ITIC triggers, where voltage tolerance parameters follow the ITIC boundaries. These triggers and recordings indicate excessive voltage drop or rise in voltage outside those heavy black lines. Consider the relationship between voltage and time. You know a power supply's ability to ride through a low voltage event is affected by not only how low the voltage dropped, but also how long the voltage dropped. In fact, many, if not most, power supplies can maintain full output even if the input voltage drops to zero, as long as the voltage returns to a sufficiently high value quickly enough. This complex relationship between voltage drop, also known as retained voltage, and time make it interpreting data, especially waveform data, difficult, but not with the Power Xpert meters. By capturing and computing the time versus magnitude data, then classifying this in different levels of severity, it is easy to search and sort the data to locate not only the most serious issues, which improves your uptime, but also identifies those events that can be ignored, saving you time. And don't worry that you're missing anything. With the Power Xpert 8000, additional hardware allows the meter to capture data at 6 million data samples per second, fast enough to capture a lightning strike. Strategically placing a Power Xpert 8000 at your incoming service or critical loads can help you determine what may be happening to your system. And because Power Xpert uses open data storage and real-time access methods and protocols, data can be accessed directly using your existing monitoring and analytics system without translation and without the purchase of vendor proprietary software. These open standards mean that programs like Microsoft Excel can point to a Power Xpert meter and display and plot any Power Xpert trend, alarm summary, or even ComTrade waveform files without needing to be translated with vendor proprietary tools. For example, here is Excel zooming and panning through a more than 1,000 cycle waveform capture retrieved directly from the Power Xpert meter. But you don't need to connect the meter to external systems to be impressed by what it can do. Let's say you were called in to troubleshoot why a system malfunctioned. You aren't sure of the cause, but you wanted to eliminate power as a cause. While you can search a long list of logged events looking for a smoking gun, you can more easily sort event data by two methods on the Power Xpert meter, ITIC curve and the event calendar. In the Power Xpert 6000 and 8000, the automatic ITIC curve generation calculates the time magnitude correlation and plots all the events that have occurred on your power system. From there, you can sort to look at the data, from the worst events first, what the Power Xpert meter classifies as level 8 events, all the way down to other events that may or may not cause you problems, what we call level 4 and level 2 events. On the other hand, maybe the problem wasn't caused by a voltage sag or swell, and so won't appear on a time magnitude event list. What if you wanted to look at all the anomalies correlated to a date, a certain production shift, or some other known times? To get a quick overview of all events, but still be able to categorize by type, the calendar view gives you an easy method of zeroing in on problems. For example, if you knew that a drive dropped out on a certain date, you could view that date and determine which event caused the downtime with your drive. This is definitely one of those things that Power Xpert owners don't always know about. The calendar view goes even further to show you patterns of data sorted by severity and type. Finally, the demand comparison is a great tool for facility owners and anyone who wants to understand patterns in your demand charges. For example, at one facility, using this demand function, we determined that about 7:30 a.m., the loads in a commercial building all came to life at about the same time, including lights, HVAC, and receptacle loads like computers. Because of this, there was a 200 kilowatt peak early in the day almost every day. At $12 a kilowatt demand, this meant that the customer paid about $2,400 a month in extra demand charges because of this peak demand, even if it only happened one time during the month. By closely watching this on the Power Xpert meter, we were able to fine-tune the HVAC system to pre-cool and preheat the building starting at 4 or 5 a.m., saving the customer a lot of money every month. The demand comparison is also a great way to illustrate demand reduction techniques for utility incentive programs.
I'm Ed Spears, manager of our Power Quality Experience Center here in Raleigh, North Carolina. We use several Power Xpert meters and specifically utilize the aux channels for our demos. Many PX meter users don't realize you can add aux channels. With the auxiliary channel option, you can monitor three extra voltage channels, and you could look at the incoming or outgoing voltage on a UPS, transformer, or other device to make direct comparisons of power conditioning effectiveness. Here's how we use them on our UPSs. Here at the Raleigh Experience Center, we can show you how our 9395 UPSs work in double conversion, variable module management, or VMMS, and high efficiency mode, or ESS. With the auxiliary channels on the Power Xpert meter, I can show you the input and output voltage before and after a voltage anomaly to demonstrate the fast transfer time during our ESS mode of operation. As you can see here, the transition time for ESS is less than 2 milliseconds. Additionally, with 5 current channels standard on the PX meters, we have the ability to see all 3 phases of input current and at least 1 phase of output current using the neutral or ground channel to monitor that output current. This gives us a very precise picture of exactly how quickly we can detect and respond to an incoming power anomaly, but also provides the actual transition waveforms so the viewer can confirm that in a UPS application, the output voltage and current are undisturbed during a significant utility power event. And as described previously, we can select events for viewing based on the ITIC curve display, the event list, or the event calendar. The Power Xpert meter can be installed in the switchboard or switch gear associated with the UPS. And in some cases, the meter may be located inside the UPS I/O area. In addition to the benefits provided by the aux channels, the PX meters also offer other benefits, including the comparison of UPS input and output voltage and current harmonics, phase balance, and power factor. This ensures that the UPS is doing its job, conditioning the power, providing isolation from harmonics, and not just acting as a battery in a box.
Hello, I'm Don McComas, Eaton's Chief Engineer for Metering. Power Xpert meters have always been a part of the Power Systems Experience Center. Our experience centers are the perfect place to demonstrate the benefits of power quality and energy monitoring. Each year, thousands of people visit our experience centers to see demonstrations of power quality problems and solutions using actual power equipment. During these demonstrations, Power Xpert meters capture and display the kinds of real-world power quality events that can happen in facilities like yours. These events can result in lost productivity from unplanned equipment downtime. Customers tell us that they love the advanced energy and power quality graphics in the meter's embedded web server. These graphics help to analyze power quality events and understand energy usage patterns. The Power Xpert meter's graphical user interface now uses HTML5 technology, which eliminates the need for browser plugins. With HTML5 pages, trend charts, event waveforms, ITIC plots, energy and demand comparisons, event calendar and summary views are all easy to view using standard browsers on either computers or on mobile devices, such as tablets. I hope this video encourages you to check out Eaton's family of Power Xpert meters. If you already have Power Xpert meters, be sure to take full advantage of their advanced features to help optimize your facility uptime and energy usage.
Here at the Power Systems Experience Center, we can show you how to take advantage of your Power Xpert meter and demonstrate some things that you may not have seen before. You'll walk away with a new appreciation of the Power Xpert meters for troubleshooting and analyzing your power system. Contact us or your local Eaton representative to schedule a visit to the Power Systems Experience Center today.